Why is it not showing up? Wrong thing. There we go. The hell? Oh. Huh? What is going on with this? For some reason, my stream is not showing what I actually have. Let's see. Okay, yeah, that's not showing properly. Okay, yeah, that's not showing properly. Fuck. That won't work. Yes. Window capture.
So, only one missing is the actual DM.
There we go. Yep. And I finally got the stream working properly there.
Man, just complain the only one we're missing is the DM, and the DM pops up.
Yep.
And mention the stream. Finally, it's working.
Share stream, copy.
Can anybody hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah, you're coming in now.
Awesome. All right, how's everybody doing today?
Better than last week.
Glad to hear it.
So where we left off is we were in an encounter and we almost lost Sinesh.
I saw that every single attack that was done towards me was had missed, so.
One hit. And then he got struck by lightning.
Sounds about right, yes.
Yeah.
So, everybody all logged in and good to go?
Yep.
It's pulling up now.
Alright, cool. So, quick recap for anybody that was not here yesterday.
Yesterday.
Last week, you know. That time in the before time. Essentially, the party made it up to the shelf in the mountains where the bones were. Discovered that they were the bones of an ancient bronze dragon. Found a knight that was guarding and kind of tending to the bones. This guardian mentioned a temple to the blind god that had been set up in this dragon's lair, and made a deal with the party that in exchange for the property of the dragon's one-time friend, he would basically act as a guide to the lair, and as long as the party helped him retake the lair, we'd give whatever property this friend had had. And with that, the party delved into the lair and has made a fair bit in, finding a rather trap-filled, flooded set of chambers, which were currently occupied by some oozes that the party is now trying to whittle down. And that is pretty much, I believe, where we left off. So, hopefully I didn't miss anything. Everybody's ready to hop back in. I will bring everybody over. And with that, it would be Galen's turn.
It is the start of... So I'm, again, heading towards the room. I'm taking both my action and bonus action to dash.
Alright, and your speed is 15, correct?
Yes, because I do not have any. So...
So that will give you now to 30 because of the difficult terrain. Anything else as you get there and are able to see probably at least one of
the door is open?
Yes.
Okay. I actually need to see something. Oh, wow, that's actually a lot bigger. Why is that bigger? Oh, so that's a... Okay, so psychic teleportation is a bonus action. I'd like to... And I can see through, like, there's no... the door is not barring my way.
Correct.
Alright, so I'd like to teleport here with psychic teleportation.
Alright.
I am actually going to specify.
Don't forget, we are underwater.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it for my turn.
Okay.
As I use my action to dash.
Right. Henrette, you are up.
Oh, shit. Let's see.
Continue on towards the
Yeah, just continue on wherever I can see.
Alright, so being that you...
It is all underwater, so you're in... Remember, the condition of difficult to train for me is same for everyone that doesn't have a swim speed.
Yes. Plus the fact that you are also holding your breath unless you are able to breathe under the water.
Nope.
I'm probably the only one who can.
If I had known we were going underwater, I would have chose different subspecies. Subclass. But no. Yeah, let's just start it. Just swim as close as I can.
Oh, Crystal. I just noticed that our character sheets are different.
Yep.
Whether you're using the default sheet or the tidy sheet.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm out of first level spells.
Remember, if it's got a verbal component, it's going to cause you to start to drown.
Yep.
Which every single one of my spells has.
And you just had to be brought back up, so...
I know, I can't heal myself without drowning.
Were you unconscious underwater?
Yes.
Then I don't think you have any breath left in your lungs.
Or at least what passes as lungs for a slime. For an ooze.
V is verbal, right?
Yes.
Yes.
So yeah, no, like, every spell is all like, yeah, I know. Crystal's also trapping me. Does Crystal notice this door?
Crystal does notice that door, yes.
Okay.
Is it also closed? That... Oops, and also there's a door here. None of the doors are technically closed, it's just so that I can kind of control the light and how far you're able to actually see.
Alright, Crystal relays, because Psychic Whispers is still active, to Aelin that the jellies seem to only be affected by blunt damage. And is going to target that one, and we're going to see if that works.
Alright, and that critically hits.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I was on the combat tab, and yeah.
Supposed to be unarmed?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nothing happens to it, because...
Yeah, it takes the damage, but not a whole lot.
Does it again.
And it is destroyed.
Alright, Crystal just just motion to Sinesh, because Cure Wounds does okay. that's what I did use. I believe I did use that. Yeah. And use Cure Wounds, so, yeah. Puzzle just gonna go out and get more air.
Alright. So as you start to swim by, one of the slimes takes a swing at Crystal, missing. Going to take an action to some cash. Anything else for Crystal?
Not unless I can use my bonus action to dash.
No. Not unless you're rogue.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Let me.
Here, it is going to move to target Sinesh. Hit!
Out. This may be the end of Sinesh.
I'm on my way.
Feili, you are up.
Cool. I'm going to start with a Starlight Step to go 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, and then swim an additional 30 feet.
Okay.
30. Because I do have to swim speed at this point, and you can breathe water at this point.
Okay. Yeah, because didn't you alter yourself?
Yep.
When you first, yeah. And that, yeah, probably still up.
Oh yeah, no, definitely. Let's see. How are the oozes looking?
Jellies, whatever. They seem to have taken considerable damage at this point.
Alrighty then. I can see three of them. We're gonna hit each of them with yeah, I'm gonna upcast this a lot. Two magic missiles. Because I'm casting it at fourth level, so I should be using six, I believe, correct?
Yeah. Correct. Okay, so that one is dead. Hurt. And dead.
I can see this, but it's saying I'm blocked.
It has cover from where you are.
I don't know.
It looks like.
I would assume it would be like partial cover, but I don't know how partial cover works with magic missile.
Generally, it would be full cover because of the straight corridor. I think you're able to see it just because of how Foundry handles light and shadow.
Magic missile is a sight, so it is.
But like, I couldn't see it at all.
You can't see it at all. It's an automatic hit, but it does count as like targeting. So you need spell sniper.
Yeah.
Well, in that case, I guess I waste two magic missiles. Had I not been able to see that, I wouldn't have probably cast it as high, but whatever.
Yes, probably, unless you would have upcast it for the extra.
I specifically was aiming for two at each. Though I don't actually have a second level spell that would be appropriate for four, so, whatever.
Anything else for Feylight?
That was my bonus action and action. And movement.
Alright. So Sinesh.
Just heal yourself. You're already taking water. Just heal yourself and book it.
So I will go ahead and, since I'm already having problems with no air, going to cast, where is it? There it is. Cure Wounds, 4th level, myself.
Don't suppose you can use teleportation magic.
I can't. And then move my 15.
Yeah, for anyone not arcane, you don't get teleportation magic.
And that'll be my turn.
Yeah. And specific subclasses. Which is why Fae Touched is actually really good of a feat.
Now, the real question is, how much damage did I take that round from not having any oxygen?
That will be determined at the top of the next round.
Actually, yeah, it's my turn. I should take damage from oxygen. Yes, I just realized that, like, the last round I had literally just healed, and I completely missed the fact that was Cure Wounds was vocal, so.
Yep. That's why I was not healing myself till after I went down.
Remaining jellies attack the nearest enemy, who coincidentally happens to be Sinesh. Now, Crystal and Sinesh is the only ones that were attacked. Please give me a Constitution saving throw. All right. You're both managing to hang on to your breath. And six roll. Okay. Aelin, you are up.
Alright. Yeah. Closest one to Sinesh.
There is legit one that I'm on top of, too, so.
That one hits. It is still up.
And then the bonus attack.
Alright. And that one is dead. Anything else?
And. Aelin's gonna swim over here. Which is as far as Aelin can get. And get ready to go out, because I believe that spear is going to be recharging.
Fair enough. Penrat.
I'm gonna do the same thing, but. I would do the same thing, but then Faelie and the other lady, I'm presuming, would be in the same spot as me. I'll say go that way.
Oh, you're in the same spot. They already swam forward.
Right here?
Yep.
The other one.
That would bring you to here because of the other two being in front of you.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Anything?
here. Care to do anything else? I wasn't going to start pushing him forward.
Crystal.
Yeah, Crystal's gonna cure wounds at second level. Yeah. And then an additional 15 feet swim speed.
Okay. I will say as Crystal swims along, notices a door here.
Okay.
Please, Crystal, why did we go that way? Anything else?
Crystal does not go away. Crystal takes note of that going past.
Okay.
There. Yeah, Crystal is currently focused on air.
Okay.
Yeah, because... when no one in the party has potions of water breathing.
Mm-hmm.
Well, because we were so expecting to...
water breathing spell at that.
I had something.
Yeah, you had something for yourself. And mainly Sinesh could go an hour.
Until I went down, but yeah.
Yeah.
Billy, you are up.
I'm trying to move my
character. Are you in... you're not in token slot, I don't think. Oh, oops, sorry about that.
Hello there. I'm just going to take them all down, I think. Right, yeah. Same thing I did last time.
Fireball?
Each. No.
Yeah, it takes the nest down the rest of the way. Only got 28 HP.
She ready?
Fireball underwater. Fireball would go, oh, by the way, it's out.
Not with her capabilities.
I could turn it into ice. Or lightning. Yeah.
Yeah, there's already a lightning spirit in the room.
Yeah, Lenny, isn't that probably a good answer? Kind of want to be shocked.
Yeah, no, we've already got, what was it, 3 lightning spears already?
Yep.
Yep.
Right.
Javelins, yeah.
It's my turn.
Alright.
Target myself, heal myself again at 4th level.
Alright.
And then move the max I can. Which would actually be here.
Crystal's doing the same and is going to... that way? No. Doesn't do that.
And your guide swims in and looks around, seeing that the jelly creature thingies seem to be dead. We'll try to grab for the spear. Tries to pull it out, but is unable to yank it out of the ground where it has been embedded. Aelin, you're up. Sorry, what was that, Ben, right?
I'm sorry, what? A young bronze dragon?
I don't know what you're referring to.
The guy is with us, so don't worry about him.
Okay.
Aelin signals for a young bronze dragon to help.
Alright, go ahead and make a strength check with... sorry, not strength. Athletics check with advantage.
Ooh, not cool. Way.
Aelin is able to pull the spear out of the ground and is now holding the spear.
Five. Okay, so that was five. Back would be... And it is now in the hallway, taking the spear out.
Okay.
So that's turn, and... Wait, no, that's not the full turn. That's action. And we'll... How many times can I use? Need to update that. We'll also use that to move all the way down.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else?
No, that's it. Aelin's okay. Just trying to get. Aelin's getting the javelin out.
All right, Penrat.
Yep, the caboose is coming. The caboose is coming in one step at a time. I'm getting there. Yeah.
Are you going to dash or?
Okay, yeah. So I'm going to actually remove that spell slot because I'm kind of not healing. I actually put it out outside my turn. No.
Sure, I'll dash. Still take 40.
That way.
Crystal.
Alright, you're up. So yeah, healing I put up when I shouldn't have, counting that, Crystal just moves 15 feet, barely past Aelin, who theirs, and Aelin has basically dismissed the psychic whispers, because we're all pretty low on stuff.
Okay. All right. Fair enough. Feely.
We haven't gone down this way yet, have we?
Nope.
This way? Or that way? No. Maybe not.
Do you guys want me to go that way, or do you need me to help take somebody out?
Sure. I believe... right now, I think the only thing causing encounter is just the...
Drowning.
Javelin. And you have no idea. There's no communication. Nobody can communicate.
Talking out loud.
Yeah, no one can communicate with you.
You can nod.
Well, I'm pretty sure the only one in there is Penrat.
Yeah. So Penrat's the only one that would be able to reply.
Do you need I'll look at Penrat. Do you need help getting out?
Wait, hold on. Alter Self does not allow voice sound to travel properly.
It allows you to breathe underwater.
Yeah, it doesn't allow you to speak underwater.
Fair enough.
Yeah, probably not.
Cool. I'll just start making my way back. Yep. That's all.
All right. So dash.
All right, I'm actually going to end up dashing, trying to get out of here as quick as possible.
All right, it should take me there.
Oh, I just realized, technically I should be moving Aelin at 40, not 15, at 20, not 15, because 40 move speed.
Aelin's this is 30 in the character sheet.
Crystal.
Oh, Crystal, sorry.
Yeah, and 5 feet around me, so everyone starts to turn 5 feet around me, we'll get 40, so.
Okay.
I was saying I should have been moving Crystal.
Yeah.
But you might say Aelin first, but yeah.
Anything else for Sinesh?
Nope.
No. New friend starts swimming out after Feli.
Alright, Aelin pops up here, notices the door, and is going to once again, use it to get out the door.
Okay.
Oh, yep. That's 7 feet. 7 feet from. Like Aelin's just out.
Okay. Aelin doing anything while they are out?
Aelin's gonna dash. Well, because psychic teleportation is an action. Bonus action.
Right.
So she's just gonna dash towards the javelins.
Okay.
And I'll be right back.
Alright. Penra!
Where am I going? Screw myself. Where do I go? I think to myself.
You were able to see the direction everybody went because of the illumination in that room, at least until the spear was taken out. So you would have seen that they all went. Yeah. Dashing, that would confuse me. Top of my mind.
Right. Hello. I am back.
Welcome back.
Anything else for Peter?
No, nothing.
Crystal?
And, Crystal is dashing.
Okay.
And, the moment she's up, immediate breath. Immediate gasp of breath. And coughing up whatever water.
Alright, fair enough. Feili.
I will also dash. And get stuck here because I can't go any further.
An encounter.
Because we're still in the encounter movement.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why, the javelin's underwater.
And then I move as much as I can.
Dash?
Of course I would dash, but I don't know if I'd be able to get through with the dash.
And
alright, Aylin's just Aylin just immediately drops the javelin on top of the covers, so the first thing Aylin does look straight at Snesh and go, do you have a death wish?
No, I do not.
I don't know if you guys saw, there was at least two doors, I think, that we passed that we didn't go through.
Yeah. Saw it as well.
Yeah, so one, two, three. You passed three doors that you did not explore.
Which doors?
I saw this one and this one.
And there was also one here as well.
Ah. Cool.
Oh, that's weird.
Give me a second. Do I have access? I forget if I've used my, quick... I have not. What we're going to do right now is I'm going to ensure that we can all talk to each other when we go back down. Yes? Are we all in agreement?
Mm-hmm.
Anyone not want to be telepathically linked?
No. Nothing against this.
Wonderful. I'm going to use my special ability to ritually cast telepathic bond.
That's weird.
All right, you are all now telepathically bonded. What would you all like to do now?
Okay, I cannot ping you anymore, and I can't do the finger point anymore.
You have to long right click.
Yeah, the module that is the X is no longer maintained, and I had to take it out.
Okay. Yeah, I have to left click.
Yeah, I'm disappointed. I like that module.
Alright. I can go back and explore if we need me to explore. Because I don't need to worry about things like going slowly or breathing for an hour.
I can go with you. I just need to heal up first.
And with that, you see me go and cure wounds myself again.
And I'm leaving my spellbook safe out of the water.
Alright, I'm going to head back in. I'm going to check this first door here.
Yep.
Alright.
Should we go straight or turn?
And you also notice the door to the north as well.
Turn.
Cool. And what do you see here?
Maybe a mistake. But too late.
Too late indeed.
What did you do?
Oh, hey.
Oh, I'm relaying everything that we see to you guys.
You see simple wooden planks with bedding covered in mildew are spread around the room. Shelves lining the walls hold empty scroll cases, and a layer of ash covers the ground.
Is the room also filled with water?
It is not.
I was going to say, if there's ash on the ground, no.
I didn't think so.
If you guys want to come in, there's an open air area pretty close.
And it looks like there are beds in here as well.
Oh, I would not be sleeping in here if you paid me. Or meditating, but...
Yeah, no. Aelin is heading towards the other one. This one, which.
I'm going to poke at those spell scrolls. Or scroll pieces, whatever.
First off, for Aelin, as you go through, you see a door to the south, and you see a door to the north.
He immediately guesses where the south is and goes straight north.
All right. So you go to the north, and I will get to that in one moment. Finley, you said you're examining the scroll cases?
Yes.
The room appears to have been looted already and pretty well gone through. However, if you kindly give me a quick perception check, please. Right. You do not see anything on that shelf. Snatch, do you search the room at all?
Yes.
All right, go ahead, give me a perception check. As you are examining the room, looking at one of the beds, you see a wooden object peeking out from under one of the pillows.
I go to it and examine it.
So you take it out from under the pillow?
Yep.
Cool. Alright, the object is in your inventory under weapons.
Huh.
By the way, this would give me a good way to just teleport to your book and back.
Other room. Aelin. Walks.
It's a,
passes through the door.
Is that stealth?
Stealth through the door. Cool.
I will roll stealth.
Oh, go ahead and give me your stealth roll, please.
That's a good item.
I'm laughing at that. Okay. Stealth, because
two more levels.
Yeah, yeah. Balin telepathically recites to everyone what she's found.
Well,
are there any enemies in the room? Like, obviously on the map there or not, like, is there anything suspicious in the room? Which is why she stealthed.
Okay, so you find a large chamber. Looks significantly large to be able to comfortably house an ancient dragon. In the center, you see a large monolith rising to a height of 10 feet. Growing from the stone floor and covered in runes and the symbol of an eye with two stars across its iris. A mound of orange rust lies along the western wall. So, the room is sparsely furnished with ornate pieces that are mostly broken and decrepit due to decades of disuse. Hovering above the monolith, you see a cloud of ghostly apparitions swirling about. Faces forming this cloud shriek in silent rage, a green glow emanating from their jaws and empty eye sockets that seem to follow your gaze.
So from that, I'm assuming they can see me.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. I was like, 13 stealth. I was like, ah. So yeah. Aiden heads straight for the door and tries to open it.
Cool. But before you do that, go ahead and roll your initiative.
Okay.
Cool. So, you run to the door. And as you step on this bronze indentation that's in the ground...
No, she's going around through the cobwebs.
Cool. As you go around this bronze indentation, go ahead and give me a... acrobatics check.
What? How?
Your foot.
Oh wait, yeah, no, I'm not.
Your foot.
That makes sense. I'm not
on the outer edge, and you slips slightly, and you hear this kind of or sound, and notice the oily sheen that had been covering it slowly kind of form into a pudding that takes a swing at you.
Double uncanny dodge?
Yeah, I don't know why.
And you are now at the door. Try to open the door?
Try to open the door and get across, because I still do have the movement. And the moment she's across, she closes the door.
Cool.
She slams it, and it is immediately telepathically, monster, 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 big room, monster. Monster. And also it flies trap immediately after the door. Or
Did Panret and Crystal follow everybody into the room with the beds?
Yeah. Crystal is in the room with the beds.
Mm-hmm. Alright.
Crystal is just taking moment to take a breath.
Panret, yeah, Crystal would be... you went also?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, 10 points of damage is not that bad. Actually, yeah, during that time, I keep saying I would, probably had Crystal pass the potion of healing to Aelin, so.
And Crystal to Aelin?
Yeah. Yeah, that should have been a few sessions back.
All right, that is transferred.
I'm somewhat disappointed in that acrobatics check, but I didn't take proficiency in it, so it makes sense. Not to mention, I wasn't aware of that either.
What's everybody doing?
Seeing as she just slammed the door behind her, I tell her to move out of the way.
Aelin moves.
I get right up to the door. I crack it open just enough to see what she was talking about.
Okay.
And with that, I end up trying to cast a spell through the open doorway. Acid arrow, third level.
Okay.
All right. Close the door right after.
Okay. The acid arrow did hit.
Now the real question is, did it look like it did a lot of damage or not much?
I mean, it hit, but assuming you closed the door right away,
I wouldn't know.
Yeah, I mean, you...
Aelin's looking at Sinesh and says... Yeah, Aelin's looking at Sinesh and Talia goes... That's the trap. The monster is above a pedestal. It's got multiple eyes.
Yeah, you're not sure if it had any effect or not.
Would I know that what I attacked was a black pudding or was something else?
You'd probably know it was black pudding.
Oh wait, I said Crystal, not Aelin. I meant Aelin.
Aiden, that trap, it's actually a black pudding. I've damaged it, but I don't know how bad. We need to clear that room out so that we can continue on. Faye, would you like to throw a fireball in there?
Do we want it fired? Do we want something else? Let me know.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, there's some kind of spirit in there as well, so... Radiant damage, maybe? If you've got that?
Let me check.
Aelin did mention that that was a room where an ancient bronze dragon would reside. As she was still relaying across until seeing the monster, then she bolted.
Yeah. Can't do radiant. I can do thunder.
Let's go ahead and try that. I will move out of the way for you.
I don't feel like much can deal with thunder damage very well, can it?
I think specifically elementals or possibly giants are really... So yeah, I think you're right.
There's a couple of things. They're normally pretty obvious.
Yeah. I'm thinking along the same lines.
Cool. Preparing to cast Thunderball. As soon as the door is open. If somebody wants to open the door for me?
Crystal will do that if Sinesh doesn't.
Sinesh moves off to the side, opens the door.
Because yeah, you can slide through the...
It's just going to take up the entire room. Cool. Close the door.
Nope.
I don't know if that killed them or not, but it hurt.
Look at us playing it smart.
So you hear this reverberating thunder booming and echoing from the next chamber. I feel like everybody should be on initiatives now. So
maybe just a little bit.
Let's do that.
Also, wait, is our knight friend also on the telepathic circle?
Oh, so the pudding's still alive.
Offered everybody who was in that room, if the person accepted, yes.
So the real question is, did they accept it or no?
Your new friend?
Yeah.
Yes, your new friend accepted.
Oh, wow. Wow, Crystal managed to beat out Aelin. Alright, any comments from the knight about the room?
Well, this was supposedly the dragon's personal chamber. If any part of the dragon's effects survived, they should be beyond this chamber. And most likely, when the cult of the blind god came in, they probably would have desecrated the chamber. So it's hard to say what magics might be in play within that room.
Alright, so Aelin is actually going to move in front of Faye. And yeah, Aelin, door. Yeah, Aelin's gonna go in.
I just saw acid arrow got removed.
Sorry, not Aelin, Crystal. Crystal's gonna go in.
I just saw acid arrow was removed from the black pudding without the secondary damage taking effect.
Yep.
Yeah. Shields drawn. Magic weapon should still be active because. Anything specific about the eyes or anything?
No, you basically just see this cloud.
I'm going to divine sense that. I am going to keep the door open but shield up while I'm doing divine sense.
Okay. So you get the feeling that the creature floating above the obelisk is definitely undead, and the room is hallowed.
Alright, close the door. okay, so the eyes are undead. So there is that.
If they are weak enough, I can take them out in one hit.
Yeah, and Crystal moves back. Keeping everyone within the aura.
So this is what
I realized that I should have done that, and I checked and saw that it was an action, so yeah. Yeah, that is.
That's what you're saying.
Visually, that's obviously undead. Aelin would not be able to tell the difference, and Crystal would definitely check with Divine Sense, so. Also, I've only got 2 level 1 spells on Crystal, so I'm very much tempted to actually take a long rest in this chamber. As terrible in condition as it is. But I figured with the door open, I could use Divine Sense that way.
Yes. So.
And, yeah.
Anything else for Crystal?
No, I do not have many bonus action things other than, magic weapon, which, and divine favor, which neither are going to be useful at this point, so.
Alright. Aelin.
Aelin's going to sneak away, open the door, will target that and will chuck 2 psychic blades. Ooh! And then close the door and move back. Actually, no, she's gonna move behind Bailey. And it's going to stay behind Feely.
Okay.
Yeah, we're low on spell slots. Spell slots, so choosing the fight is probably the best thing to do.
Alright. Dinesh, you're up.
I move up. Open the door.
All right, as you open the door, those individuals who are prompted to do so, kindly, scroll, 1 sec. Let's make a... Kindly make the request. All right. Mm-hmm.
Great. That's so more than half the party.
No, it's only two people. Alright, so that is Snatch.
Yeah, I don't have Lesser Restoration. I use my two. I use my last.
I level still two have spell Lesser. Slots.
Yeah, but if you're mind controlled. Yeah.
I'm just using the turned icon because it's going to be a quick reminder for me. Alright, so, Sinesh, what would you like to do?
Well, I can't do anything because paused.
Oh, there you go.
I move in and around the black pudding, targeting this guy, so I can get within 5 feet of him, and do destroy undead.
Alright, so you have to do turn undead first.
Turn undead? Okay. Yeah. Where is it? Ah, oh, there it is. Turn undead. Usability.
Alright, one. Damage. Alright, you present your holy symbols. Some saving throw.
I rarely get to use my channel divinities.
Level, something thrown. It's destroyed.
I'm guessing I've used mine more than yours, but I've not used Inspiring Smite at all.
First time using this character for me to use Channel Divinity.
Yeah.
Well, that's due to the fact that it's either Charm Oozes or Turn Undead. Which I probably could have used Charm Oozes earlier. I could still probably use it here, too.
I could use Inspiring Smite, which just gives us temporary hit points if you're within a radius of me.
It nat 20'd that.
Yeah, I just saw green and just like, oh.
So, is there anything else Sinesh would like to do?
And then I will move.
You have 40 feet of movement, just so you know. You start your turn with
35, 40. Move back, which means attack of opportunities, but...
Yep. Alright, so... Spectral Congregation takes an attack of opportunity on you.
Again, we do not need to lose our cleric.
Sorry,
just having this cleric and technically this paladin, we have essentially a single healer. Misses. Oh.
And then.
So Nash was on the other side of the door.
No, this was as he was moving past the,
Oh, yeah.
And because it was acid damage, I only took half damage.
Oh, yeah. Right. Yeah, forgot about that. Hold on 1 second. So that took out... All right, so that reduced it by 17. So...
Yeah, they already did the half damage.
There we go. That's correct.
Wait, what? I'm resistant to acid.
Yeah, no, you already took the half damage, and he just restored the damage.
Yes.
Yep. Yes, he did. If certain people who are able to do if certain people that are able to divinely sense the nature of places were to take a longer look into the room, they may know why.
Okay. Yeah, I'm yeah. That would be Crystal.
All right, anything else for Snatch?
I close the door behind me.
Cool.
And that's it.
Cool.
Even though I'm resistant to acid, I took full damage from that black pudding. Be careful in there.
Penrat, you are up.
And you have 40 movement speed because you started 5 feet from me.
More than that then, right? How much? It increases by how much?
If you start 5 feet within my radius, 10 feet within me at level 18, you get your movement speed is up to 40. You gain 10 bonus movement speed.
So,
Penrat, yeah.
Penrat's a monk.
Yeah, Penrat is a monk.
Starts at 40.
Sure am.
Yeah, and
the aura. Do anything yeah. Monk related? Well, it just looks stupid.
Alright, so you open the door?
The door needs to be open. Yeah, the door needs to be open if you need to move, if you're gonna move through it, so.
Yeah, anyone can. He's on the stairs.
Is the black pudding still there?
I don't know. Penrat, go ahead and make a perception check if you want to look for the pudding.
Yeah.
Penrat, you see the pudding next to you. Go ahead and make a charisma saving throw. Cool.
Why is everyone being turned?
Couldn't even do.
So, what would you like to do, Penrat?
I'm gonna blast it. My new Eldritch Blasts.
Oh, yeah. Right. So that hits.
And since I didn't really do a melee attack, I can't really do a second strike, so.
Bear in mind, moving off would trigger an opportunity attack.
Yeah,
all right. Go for it. Fitnesses.
And we're set.
We'll move up and he will signal for somebody to open the door.
And of course I opens it.
And Aelin's ducked down to prevent any sort of upper thing.
Shoots his crossbow at it. And then he signals for the door to be closed again.
Oh, just leave it open.
Alright. Feli, you are up.
Assuming it was left open after I said that?
Yep.
Cool. You ready
enough for Thunderbolt?
No, I'm going to be a little bit... I have two spell slots left, or like three spell slots left, and I'm using one of my higher ones to use force instead. Ugh. That was a horrible damage roll. Now you may close it as you please.
Leave it open.
What?
All right, Crystal goes in. Wait. Crystal goes in.
Has Crystal seen it before?
Actually, yeah, because Crystal did the divine sense, and then we entered initiative. But Crystal's going straight towards it.
Okay, before you do, you will have to make your charisma save.
Go ahead, give it to me.
Come back with it! Go!
Yeah, no, this is a paladin. Of course I'm going to make it.
Well, you would think I would have made it, being a cleric and all.
26. Of course I'm going to make it.
I rolled a 3, got 11.
Yeah, you got 17. Yeah. Yeah, but... Paladin, proficiency with charisma saves.
So, what would you like to do?
Now, Crystal is going to attack it with the longsword.
Alright, that will be a miss.
Going to try again. Is frustrated.
Parts out of the way of the blade.
Alright. How long has it been since the last... since our last fight back here with the dish?
Oh, with the dish? It's an hour, right?
Okay, so yeah. With that, so it's been an hour. So yeah, Crystal is no longer concentrating on magic weapon.
Okay.
So Crystal is going to... finding that annoying, will be casting...
Philly, you were concentrating on the telepathic link, right?
I am concentrating on my alter self. Telepathic link is not concentration.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Yeah. Alright, Crystal is now using Divine Favor, so is now concentrating again.
Alright.
Don't know why I rolled damage, because I did not hit, and I cast that after attacking. But yeah, Crystal is staying in the room.
Undo your damage. Alright. That's it for Crystal?
Yeah.
Alright. Aelin!
Alright. Aelin, I am turned.
True. Turn doesn't mean turned.
Alright. Seeing Crystal just rushing, Aelin's gonna follow the same.
and will and will do these to you. I'll take that.
Okay. So that is a hit and a miss.
And that was 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, 15. Disengage from... Oh, wait, no. 15. And is going to move over the barrel. And I will take that attack of opportunity because I did do my bonus action.
All right. There is no attack of opportunity on that.
All right.
Anything else?
That's everything I can do.
All right.
Well, is my two characters, aren't I?
Probably.
At this point, just start using Sacred Flame. Aim, Feely. It's undead, so, and that's radiant.
Talk about lucky.
All yeah. right. Sinesh, you are up.
I target this thing. Real. And then I will cast... Let's see. Do I have... Yes, I do. There it is. Guiding Bolt at third level.
All right. So, before you do anything else, roll me a d4, please.
All right.
Wait, should I should have rolled for Aelin?
Nope, you're fine. Anything else for Sinesh?
Seeing as that's a action and the other thing I wanted to do was an action, I can't do anything.
Alright.
And seeing as how I'm wounded, I'm staying on this side of the door.
You should be able to hit that specter easier now. Kill it!
No. That's all I'm saying.
So yeah, since it got hit, you get automatic advantage on the next hit, whoever goes to attack it.
And it misses a second hit. Benrat, you are up.
So we're going all out now? Well, let's see.
Just be careful of that black pudding in there. We don't need you being eaten by it.
Remember, you can do space to move around corners.
Mm-hmm. This time I'm gonna walk up to the thing. This time I'm gonna totally dead. I need to go along.
And it... fails. It does not appear very damaged.
Yeah. And then as my bonus action, just disengage and...
Yep. Why doesn't Toll the Dead consume Guiding Bolt?
I don't think it does, because I believe it's a melee or a range like a bow or something like that. That gives advantage. I'm not sure.
Now it specifies the next attack roll.
Okay.
Oh, if that Toll the Dead is a roll to... Or is it just that automatic? So,
it's a saving throw.
It's a saving throw.
Okay, yeah.
Alright. Anything else for Panrak?
Nope, that's it. Just go back away.
Salvaro uses his crossbow again and takes another shot, hitting the creature.
And it took 4 points. It gained 4 points.
Paley, you are up.
Did I just see that right? It healed 4 points from the crossbow.
It was undone. Put it that way.
Oh.
Right, so swing. And what type of damage are you doing that as? As flame or?
So sacred flame, I can't change the damage type. It's just radiant.
It's a racial, so it's not.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Well, I yeah. cantrips I can't change.
Okay. So it succeeds and is undamaged. Anything else for Fele?
That is all.
Didn't the door be open? Yeah, it is open. Okay. Yeah. Crystal. Basically dying, does not care. So Crystal is going to and roll a d4 for plus 2 radiant from divinely favored.
Okay.
I'm surprised Guiding Bolt has been removed yet.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that one would have removed it, because that was an attack roll.
The...
so did the crossbow. It's basically any attack roll. Oh. It doesn't matter whether it's a spell or not, so yeah.
And it should right. only be once, if I remember
yeah,
correctly.
Once. Yeah, once. Yeah, the next, yeah. So
it's the crossbow. Okay.
That's why I'm like, wait,
yeah.
what?
Yeah, so if Guiding Bolt was still active on the thing, I would have saved... Crystal's turn and used Aelin to get sneak attack.
Anything else for Crystal?
She's going to attack again. And another... And that's 1 point of radiant damage.
Okay.
And is going to bonus attack brace. But defend from any sort of
right.
attack block. Oh, yeah, okay. So bonus attack block from anything.
Oh. Aelin.
Okay. Aelin is going to move over here. Does this count as flanking?
This would be fine.
Okay, Aelin's moving over here. Alright.
Press Alt when rolling the attack just to make sure that it does the advantage.
It's going to give it because Guiding Bolt's still active.
Alright, so. Hold up! The dagger. The dagger magical.
The dagger is not magical. If it was magical, it would have does Aelin take care of that? So
Aelin can do sneak attack.
Take that sneak attack away. If it's not magical, then take that sneak attack away. All right. So Aelin takes note of. That's also doing sneak attack damage on the dagger. So. And it will.
So it was no sneak attack.
Alright, yeah, so yeah, that's just 5. So, Aelin? Yeah.
Anything else for Aelin?
Yeah, she's going to. Bonus attack. That one she will do sneak attack.
Alright.
That was 5d6.
So that does damage.
And yeah, there's the 5d6. Also, technically the psychic blades are a d6, not a d4. They're supposed to be a d6.
Bonus
attack. Yeah, bonus attack would be d4. Yeah. Okay.
Alright, so.
Yeah. That would be 17 total.
Cool. Alright, anything else? Very low.
No, but she does comment non magical weapons are not effective.
And after. Being hit like that, the spectral congregation turns towards Aelin, lashing out at Aelin.
That explains it, life drain. Oh, wow.
Yeah, it hits hard and heals itself.
Plus six to hit? This is not doing a plus 6 to hit. Roll the 6.
Yeah, if you fail a constitution save. Which, I think that's a restoration.
No wonder that. Okay.
I currently don't have the spell slots for greater, so.
I don't have the spell slots for lesser.
I have the spell slots for lesser. Once...
I mean,
yeah, you don't have lesser.
23 down, if it hits you twice, would probably drop all of us permanently.
14. As I can cast lesser once.
Yeah, I've only got one last spell to use. After that, Crystal's gonna need a rest.
Dinesh, you are up.
Let's see. Healing word is... Okay. So, I will... I can't do anything. Game's paused.
Yeah.
I move up. Target Crystal. Healing word.
Which is a 60-foot range. So you can generally just shout and heal
moving in. Still doing it for a specific reason.
Okay.
Cast it at second level. And then turn, face the pudding, and use my channel divinity charm ooze.
Which is good.
It is ineffective.
Of course.
It's not news. That's bad.
Yep. And...
Well, was technically a news.
Yeah, technically. That's why I went and did Charm Ooze.
Yeah. Because
that's in the Ooze family.
Yeah. That's not why I didn't work.
And I step out, seeing that my Charm Ooze did not work.
Anything else for Sinesh?
Nope.
Cool. By putting Glurps forward across the doorway. Takes a swipe at the paladin type individual missing. Takes a swipe at the ooze type creature that's just trying to charm it. Some missing. Of course, why would it be missing?
And that would have taken me down to zero too if it hit. Watching ooze.
I still have lay on hands.
Watching ooze eat the news.
Penrat! What would you like to
do? What would I like to do? Good question. Now, this guy right here.
Fortunately, your punches are magical. Because you are a monk.
If only. Maybe if I did like full monk, I would have. But no. This guy here. Is this congregation. Can I actually punch it? Can I punch it?
If you'd like to do so, sure. Wait, which one are you wanting to punch? The spirits or the ewes?
The spirits.
The spirits?
Well, the spirits, I guess, probably not.
I mean, I'm trying to see if they're.
If not, I could just keep blasting it. It's not a big deal.
Alright, yes, it is incorporeal, so no, you cannot find it.
Oh.
Unless your fists are considered magical weapons.
Yeah, well, I was thinking that was like an earlier level, like you're an eighth level monk and first level. Yeah, sorry, I'm actually checking because I'm actually going to the monk page. for
I think if I was astral self, I think I'll be able to.
No, it's like every monk gets that as a baseline part of the following. While you're unarmed, certain monastery traditions specialize in the monk form, for example, you can use the monk. Some of them are unclosed. Traditions, the way of the open
hand. So yes, your punches are magical powered, six items.
Key empowered strikes. Yeah. Yeah, no, it's a 6th level monk ability. It's like an early level, and it's baseline part of the class.
Yep.
I'm like, wait, why aren't you able to punch it? I know it's a base class part. It's unaffected by your subclass. I'm looking at that. Dude, you can punch it.
I can't read.
No, the thing is, I was looking at your character sheet. It's not on, for some reason, it's not on your character sheet.
It is.
It's under passive features.
Yeah, key empowered. Yeah. Yeah, I just didn't see it. It's like right below, it's literally just below extra attack.
Right, so you punch it, and if you would just real quick, go ahead and roll me a
d4. Of course.
Another question is, how come I'm not the one having to roll these?
Alright, that's fine.
Probably because you saved.
Why isn't Crystal? Because Crystal saved.
No, Aelin. Aelin, why isn't Aelin rolling these?
Because Aelin's rolls have been high enough that whatever the d4
no,
was...
No, Aelin did not save from being turned.
I know, but the rolls that would be affected by a d4 have been high enough, they're rolling...
Ow. Yeah, sorry. Now, it's putting together now. Yeah, my apologies. Starting to get that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so yeah, that just leaves young black, bronze dragon, and Faye. Pan, you letting them know it's literally right on the other side of the door?
Hmm? Huh?
What's it about?
The black pudding.
Who, what, when, how?
We're in turn-based order. I'm assuming we all can't communicate at the across the other people's turns. Oh.
Ooh, he lost sound.
I think we maybe can.
Yeah.
It's not like it takes an action to talk.
Hmm. Let's see if this works. Mm-hmm.
I think we should probably take a rest after this.
I agree.
There's no way else is gonna work, but go for it.
You're back.
Go for it. Yep.
Like, when you weren't having sound, if you were talking, we couldn't hear you either, which...
I don't think he's back yet.
Okay.
There's his voice.
This is what I was like.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Alright, cool. Sorry about that. I am back.
Welcome back!
Alright, so Panrit, you punched it again. You did a bit of damage. Anything else?
Well, I guess I'm gonna walk over. Now I'm gonna walk over to the black sludge and try to punch that too.
Okay.
When I have a magical few strikes. And I got 25.
Alright, see that? You did a bit of damage to it. Anything else?
Let's see if this works, but I'm gonna try and stunning strike out.
Now your roll is a 14.
Yeah.
Is that everything?
Yep, that's about it.
Ow, my ear.
He is going to shoot another ineffective arrow because he's not bringing any magical weapons with him. Philly, you are up.
Do you need a real bow? Can you use a real bow?
Yes. Yes, he can.
I will throw him my bow. I need that back.
You are throwing him the bow of the night?
Yeah.
Alright.
You get this for now.
Wow.
I am going to... Oops, I'm going to pop it. Arrows over two, so that he's in range. Look at the arrows in the family gun. Yeah. Much appreciated. Cast spell, and it is now your turn, Phelan.
I cast my spell.
You can sacred flame, and it fails the saving throw, and... It seems kind of effective.
Oh, good.
Anything else?
Cut it.
Do it.
Now Crystal is going to last spell, Guiding Bolt. All right.
Got lucky with that.
Yeah. That's it.
Kill him.
Right. Oh, hold on.
Okay.
Oh, wait, no. Hold on. Bleep. Alright, that will be... Why did I do that twice? Mouse must have mouse must have acted up.
Alright, so just did the one, so second one.
That hit with advantage because I'm getting bolt, so that would be with sneak attack.
Okay.
There we go.
Well, it's dead anyhow.
And it warps and splashes into a puddle on the floor.
Okay, Aelin's gonna hand the potion back to Crystal. And Crystal's gonna take it. All enemies.
Okay.
These are all the enemies you are able to see.
I think I know what was cast on us. Bane. I have it prepared as a first level slot.
Did I just heal the... Yeah. So yeah, that's it. Potion's gone.
You're healing yourself at 5, right? Did you get your 5 back? Yes, you did.
Yeah, and...
Bobbies.
And yeah, Crystal's dropping.
That was the last of my healing.
Crystal's dropping divine thing. Yeah, Crystal's just gonna consume. Yeah, Crystal's just gonna consume.
I say we get some rest. I am completely tapped out. I cannot heal anyone from here on unless I get a rest.
I am the same. And
I wouldn't say no.
Yeah.
And at that, Silvaro kind of walks up to this door on the north wall and is looking at the doorway.
Hey, is this a door over here?
No.
Yeah.
This is the only door that you see is here.
This door is, Aelin's going to, essentially lean next to this, and rest like that.
Silvaro kind of looks at some runes that have been carved into this door, and he looks at all of you and says that I believe this might be a somewhat safer place if you are looking to rest.
That would be helpful.
According to these runes, they were using this room as a meditation room.
Can I take a look at the runes?
Sure.
Okay, I'm going to try to read them.
Just using a normal arcana check?
I mean, I guess.
No, I was asking if you, because I don't remember if you had some special name or not. Alright, so looking at the runes, you don't see anything that says otherwise to you? If you're intending to take a rest, that might be the best place for us to do it. So, what would you like to do?
Sorry, No, I'm misunderstanding or not. Other side of the door, rest, or this side of the door is safest place to take rest.
He's indicating that he believes others that the next room might be a safer place to rest.
Madeline taps Faley. Also, did Faley get the bow back?
Not yet. I wasn't sure if she was getting it back immediately, or if she wanted it back, like, after you all leave this place.
Yeah, Aelin taps freely to move. Aelin's going stealth.
Okay, go ahead and give me your stealth roll, please. Okay.
Yeah, Aelin's gonna peer into the room, check to see if there is any.
Alright, go ahead and give me a perception check, please. So, looking into the room from where you are, you see what appear to be some magical candles and a cluster of monoliths covered with runes. You also see a... You also see a wooden chest that appears to have turned to dust over the years.
Yeah, no, Aelin's gonna immediately tear that toss off. Aelin, yeah. Aelin's going to check that just out of paranoia. After literally walking into a room with a monster, she's gonna toss that knife at the chest first.
Okay. The knife hits the chest, and what's left kind of splinters apart, and the knife hits the wall behind it.
Does it, sorry, so I'm gonna ask for the check, because one, Aelin could say that out of paranoia, or would Aelin actually know about mimics?
You might have heard of mimics. Then give me a nature check. Aelin has probably heard of mimics, yes.
Alright, Aelin pops out, Aelin, steps back to the door and goes, okay, we have no mimics, this looks safe-ish.
You want so, me to go check it out, Aelin?
Yeah, no, Aelin just goes inside, and now sees this. No, door open.
Nope, door closed. Okay, so,
I said door open. Aelin's not closing that door. And if Snesh wants to come in, Snesh can come in.
Yeah, no, you're in the description. And you can open the door. Alright, so, walking inside, you see a large stone tomb whose lid depicts a knight in full regalia along the room's western wall with what appears to be an engraved text on the side.
Yeah, no, Aelin grabs the other knife and pulls him in.
Alright, so you go over to the other knife and grab it?
No. The knight that we have with us, Aelin grabs that knight, pulls him in, points at the coffin, and then calls Crystal over.
Must be the resting place of Lord Arlen.
Better to go back to the other side where we have more room and leave this place respectfully. Yeah, better to respect the tomb and not, because it looks like this place was plundered.
Would I be able to check the obelisk to see if this is the main location where the worshippers of my god were worshipping?
Crystal would actually like to do the exact same thing.
Alright, so for Crystal, are you using the divine sight, or are you looking at the obelisk.
Divine Sense is specifically check undead. I don't think Crystal's doing the same thing Sinesh is doing. If we want Divine Sense to be done again, I have two more uses of it. Right. Just to check the in case the thing.
Alright, so Sinesh and Crystal, go ahead and make your Arcana checks. Okay. Sinesh is not entirely sure, but Crystal firmly believes that this room had been converted into kind of a ready room or a meditation room for the clerics of the blind god.
Which also coincides to be Crystal's god, though Crystal is both.
But you gotta remember, Sinesh follows the blind god.
Yeah.
That's why.
Sinesh follows the blind god. Yeah, this should be a religion check.
Yeah. That's why I'm like, why am I doing Arcana?
That is true. It would be religion for
the tournament. Yeah. Yeah. Let's do that over. And we're both doing the check, so just give it to Sinesh and just have me give advantage to that, because...
Okay.
Yeah, because we're both, yeah, just give Sinesh an advantage on that.
Okay.
I'm helping out.
So, yeah, you still believe the same thing. And of course, I will remind you that you do also have the knowledge that the other room is cursed. So, there's important information there.
You said it's hollow.
I will stay in this room and rest here.
When an evil god casts hollow on a place,
it is cursed.
It's cursed.
I'm getting it.
other room. Bad place. Just saying. You know, wants to hang with it.
I can pray to my god easier in this room. So I will stay here while everybody else rests as well.
I am starting to wonder whether I should change out some spells.
When you guys decide where you want me to do this, I can set up the tiny hut.
Aelin's more than fine with just the normal beds. Because one room cursed. Probably the idea not to reside in a cursed room. Save for Sinesh, because Sinesh is news. Yeah, Crystal just advises everyone to not rest in this room whatsoever. Like, even with Tiny Hut. Because it is cursed, and Sinesh is the only one that would be immune. And Crystal does not want to risk any more dark side of the God of Light and Dark Shadow. Afflicting her, him. At this point, being tired, Crystal reverts to female, so both her. Aelin just goes back, finds, whichever bed's the comfiest.
The beds are all in pretty bad shape, covered with mildew and mold, and have been pretty much left unattended for many, many years. But sure, you could find one that, I mean, definitely one that's least objectionable, which is probably this one here, but still pretty bad.
Yeah. Keep in mind, Aelin, Rogue, does not care.
Penrith, what room do you want to be?
I think I'd be the one where family's in.
Okay.
Beds look nice.
Mm-hmm. Actually, no. Aelin would actually try for a cycle of it and spruce up the beds for everyone. Fix them up. But Crystal will stay with Sinesh.
All right. So, Sinesh and Crystal stay in the room with Salvaro, and everybody else goes into the bedroom, correct?
Yep.
And you're all taking your long rests now?
Yep. And I will be passed in Tiny Hut.
Okay.
If anyone wants to get in here with us while I'm casting this, just so you can get in later, if the choice is yours. It will take 10 minutes.
I am fine staying in here. Because I can close this door.
You're doing this, you said it's long rest, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
There's your prompts to do all your rolls and whatnot. No. Sinesh and Crystal.
Also, Aelin would no longer have that light because light spell's probably been gone.
Alright. There you go. Sinesh and Crystal, as you're kind of settling down and starting to rest, you watch as Salvaro walks over to the tomb and grabs the sides of the stone lid and with our knees lifts it up and tilts it to the sides that is resting against the wall.
Crystal will help.
Inside, you see the body of Lord Eard Whitus Dragonfriend Arden. Laid on top of the corpse, you see a longsword, a shield, and around its wrist, you see a bracelet that looks similar to the one that Faelie has.
Telepathic bond still active?
It lasts for 8 hours.
Are immediately told of that. Crystal's not letting that pass up.
This is before or after our long rest?
During. Probably an hour in.
So, I don't particularly... Really cool. Cover back up. We'll deal with it in the morning.
The Savaro is taking these items out of the tomb.
I don't know what this bracelet is, because it's not really been talked about. So,
yeah, I don't know that you were with the party at any point when they talked about that. Well, wait. Yeah, you were in the you were in the basement of the tower
when the party went down to the bottom of the stairs and there was the pedestal.
Was this during, was this before or after Crystal left?
Right before Crystal left.
Okay, so Crystal would actually...
It was right before you ran into the bullet.
Okay.
Speaking of which, what happened to the egg?
That we had.
Somebody still has it.
Oh, yeah.
I don't remember who, but somebody still has it.
Oh, wait, did Fulmac have it?
Fulmac?
I need to be right back, my dog needs to.
Might have.
From what I remember, wasn't it put into the party's bag folder?
It doesn't mention anything about it in the bag of holding.
Sorry, we didn't put it in the bag of holding because then the egg would be dead.
I'm looking at Thalmax right now. All he's got is the adamantium chain shirt and a +1 battle axe.
Yeah, there's no flipping. There, huh?
Yeah.
12.
From what I can see on nobody's inventory sheet.
Yeah.
Good thing I mentioned it.
I was thinking about it earlier.
Yeah, he has. Well, Mac would have been the only one to carry it because Crystal, left. Because it would have had to have been carried. Because if we put it in the bag of holding, the egg would be dead.
I mean, I probably could carry it. I have a fair bit of.
Yeah, but we also determined that the egg itself was heavy.
Yes.
So, I have over 100 pounds of stuff that I still can carry. I don't have any particularly... I have nothing that's particularly heavy on my persons.
Main thing is the picking it up to carry around and putting it back down for combat and rest and all that stuff.
Yeah, but the reason why we kept saying not is because the bag of holding would still kill the egg.
Yeah.
The living creature inside the egg, so yeah, that's... And Crystal left, so Crystal couldn't carry it for you guys. So... Yeah, I think Fomak had it.
Quite possible.
However, because we were still there, Aelin, the party probably would have just took it with them. Aelin would have taken it, would have left it, because Aelin would actually be interested in such creatures. Doesn't have animal handling, but... Actually, hold on. Yeah, no, neither Aelin or Crystal has Aelin. But yeah, Aelin wouldn't have let you leave that, and would if we at this point we were basically just lost it, and it was never brought up.
Alright, so Aelin would be the one that would have been taking the responsibility for it.
Being a fae creature, she would have taken the most interest in it. But I think it just slipped our minds after the start of the following session.
No problem. All right, I will toss it onto Aelin's.
I'll be right back. My dog's barking, so.
I'm probably going to have to head out soonish.
Okay. All right. How soonish? 9:30-ish.
Sounds good to me. Mm-hmm.
Well, presumably you all get your 8 hours of rest.
Yeah.
Finally come out of your restful period 8 hours later, looking around. You notice that your new friend is no longer with you in the north room. And he has moved out into the main chamber. As you guys all start waking up.
I head into the main chamber. Does it still seem like it's cursed here?
Not something you're really able to tell.
Well, yeah, I'd ask Crystal.
Right, first use of Divine Sense.
Sure. So you look around. It does still seem to be cursed, but not as much as it had been.
Edit spells.
Edit spells. Which one are you trying to edit?
Not edit spells. As in,
change out your spells. On the spell book, all the way on the right hand side, you should see a little green lock icon. If you click that, you'll be able to change stuff.
Okay, that's not working. Because it's not...
It's not listing everything you need?
No. Yeah, it's not listing everything.
Okay,
not listing all my spells, because...
I think it's everything... On the right-hand panel where the chat log is... the second from last icon is called Compendium Packs. If you click that, go to D&D Beyond, and then you should see something called DBB Spells. That'll give the full list of all the spells, and you can just drag them onto your spell sheet. And you should drop them in these unprepared spells. Should be able to do that folder.
Yeah. Alright, some of these I think are from.
Yeah, it's going to give you literally all of the sets.
Yeah, it's giving me. Yeah, D&D Beyond folder is. Oh, wait, hold on. There we go. Oh, that's a 5th level spell. Okay, can't do that. Right, Alright,
don't know what I might do. Yeah, no, I'm going to have to look at this after.
Yeah, I mean, if you make the tweaks on the D&D Beyond sheet, I could just import it next week as well.
Yeah.
But yeah, as you all come out, you find Salvaro standing in the middle of the room. Looks like he's been doing a little bit of straightening up overnight. And he looks at you all and says, I must thank you all from the bottom of my heart for all of the help in clearing out this lair. As promised, I give to you Lord Arden's effects. I hope that you will find them useful in your adventures. And he gestures by this old wardrobe where you see a shield and a sword and a bracelet that looks similar to Thales.
And I'm making sure that I am getting back my bow.
And he gives you back your glass.
Want me to be identifying these?
Yeah.
Cool. I will sit down and start casting Identify for half an hour.
Alright, it's 10 minutes an object, right?
Yeah.
Alright, so one of the item, the bracelet you recognize. It looks just like your toy.
But they're each slightly different, and I want to know what it does.
Ah, okay. Minute. So we have that one.
We could have used this.
And what was that? Works of the tower plate. Well, that's.
And then the sword and shield are just pretty basic plus one.
Yeah, no. Crystal's taking those.
Cool.
Plus one. And then shield plus one.
Now I am at 20.
So, we still do have those, I don't know who wants to grab those torques, because I'm assuming I can only wear one set.
Yes.
I will go ahead and take the new set.
Cool. I also don't know why I have this. Have the amulet of find the path. I don't have an attunement slot for it, if somebody would like to have that.
Amulet of find the path.
Alright, so now you have the new... You have the new torques on your character.
Alright.
I'm gonna head out in like a minute. So I've been having a crazy time at work, and I wanna go. I need to get some stuff done before work tomorrow, but.
Yeah, I'm going to. Yeah, I'm dropping Quilt Duel.
And Silvaro walks over to the wall, his hand along the wall, and the door opens, and he tells you that this door will take you back out of the lair and should allow you to bypass the flooded tunnels.
You know an awful lot about this lair. Who are you, really?
See one dragon's lair, you've seen them all, haven't you?
This is very different than the dragon that we met in the Shadow Plane.
Well, I can't really speak to extraplanar dragons, of course. Haven't met any of those.
It was a big swarm of insects. Tried to threaten us. Very strange.
That does sound gnarly.
Were you, by any chance, related to the dragons who lived here?
What would you make you think something like that?
Your knowledge of the place, and the fact that you knew that where we needed to go exactly.
Like I said, you know, there's only so many dragon lair architects.
Insight check.
That's what I'm doing.
You believe he's being less than truthful.
I can tell you're speaking half-truth. Please be honest.
Fine, if you must know. Thalarmus was my father.
Well, at least we managed to clear this place out for you once more.
And I do appreciate all of your assistance. If I can be of assistance to you in the future, please.
You actually let me know. It's ironic. Sinet actually has hollow, but I don't think that's going to help remove the curse.
Yeah, but I did not prepare it. I was tempted on preparing it, but I did not.
Yeah. I need to be 5th level to learn that. I don't know if it's a paladin spell or not.
Yeah,
Crystal.
Go ahead.
Yeah, Crystal bows before. Bows before Sonaro and says, "May this place serve you well. If you ever have need, at least I will come and help you."
Much appreciated. I will remember your words.
Shall we go then?
Yeah. Yeah, Aelin's like, I can't see. And wants out. Does that mean we only have the torque in the village is not needed? Or is it still?
Need all of them.
I would assume we would need it.
Yeah. No, as in, or is it still
they're still actually a Torkin village.
Yes, this is a different Tork that was quite a distance away.
So yes, there are six of them. We have two.
Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. And currently there's only 5 party members. Currently.
Yes, you don't all need to be attuned to one necessarily. You just need to possess all six.
Hey, guys, I'm going to head out. I just have to get going.
All right.
Shall we pick up next week, then?
Yep. By the way, did we level up from this place?
I am going to check. I'm not sure.
Because if we did, you can already import mine because it's already ready. But if we did not, don't have to worry about it.
Yeah, I have to see where this falls in the check.
Yeah, no, it needs to be ability score. I can't do that yet.
You guys are 8 or 9 now?
9.
We are 9.
You are 9. Okay. So. Yeah, so you have not leveled yet.
Alright. Yeah, I just have it. Sinesh leveled up and beyond. So that when it is time for level up, all you need to do is just import and you're good.
Alright, sounds good. Good game all. I will see